Welcome to your daily grip on God's Word. Today we are in Acts chapter 14. Verses 21 and 22 rose up for me. What rose up for you? Send those to me when we get done. I keep forgetting to remind you to do that. I love hearing about that and seeing how the Lord is speaking to you through His Word. Today, verses 21 and 22 out of Acts 14. After preaching the good news in Derbe and making many disciples, Paul and Barnabas returned to Lystra and Iconium and Antioch of Pisidia, where they strengthened the believers. They encouraged them to continue in the faith, reminding them that we must suffer many hardships to enter the kingdom of God. Here's my R, my reveal. Paul and Barnabas were always busy making new converts or encouraging and strengthening new believers wherever they went. We must never forget to help new believers in their faith, and to understand the road ahead, we'll see many hardships. We can't sell a bad bill of goods and tell them everything's going to be great now that they found Jesus or Jesus has found them. There are going to be hardships. There are going to be difficulties. And God's going to use those to bend us and mold us to become more like Christ each day. We need to remember that. And we need to tell others that. Here's my implementation. If you are not a natural encourager, go and find a Barnabas or two to help you to build others up for kingdom work. We must encourage our brothers and sisters new in the faith as they face life. I think Barnabas means son of encouragement. I have several people that I refer to as Barnabas in my life. I'm a natural encourager. That's part of my giftedness. And we need to have those people in our corner. You know, we need to have a Paul, we need to have a Timothy, and we need to have a foursome of guys named Barnabas that will encourage us. To help us through each day. Here's my prayer. Thank you for the encouragers in our lives. May we be strengthened by them in their lives, and may you be glorified through it all. I'm so thankful for those people that God's placed in my life that have called me up, hey man, had you on my heart today, and just wanted to let you know that I prayed for you today. And might have been the worst day of my life. Things going on that were just out of my control. And they took the time to call and encourage, or maybe they saw something I was doing in my life that wasn't up to snuff, and they pointed it out. They did it in a loving way, in a way that I learned from that and hopefully got rid of that. I'm thankful for those. I hope you are too. Let me pray for you on our way out. Father, I do thank you for those that you've given us to encourage us, to help us along the way, and Father, to help us to see the hidden spots in our lives that we can't see. Father, I pray that you continue to use us as we encourage other believers. Lord, give us wisdom to not only spread the seed to get it to start growing, but Father, as it begins to grow, to come back and to encourage and lift up and help them along their way, just like Paul and Barnabas did. Thank you for their example. Lord, thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Have a blessed day, and I will see you tomorrow.